स्टूडेंट, होप यू हैव कम्प्लीटेड द पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू, फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन पार्ट वन, फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन पार्ट टू. हियर द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन पार्ट थ्री, दैट इज रिलेटेड टू योर एक्सरसाइज. आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स विद यू एंड आई हैव रिटन आंसर्स ऑल्सो फॉर यू, सो दैट सम ऑफ यू समटाइम मे हैव डाउट. सो for the better clarification I have written the questions and sharing with you, and beyond it some other important question also I will post and you need to write. Okay, so if I talk about the question answers given in your exercise is given here. These questions are given to you. The first one question is in this manner will be, you can see the complete sentence. So the first one question is about, describe the circumstances leading to the outbreak of revolutionary protest in France. Right? This question already we discussed. You remember how we discuss it? So that we discuss under the three headings, five different headings we discuss. You just add the statement, the circumstances leading to the outbreak of revolutionary protest in France. The circumstances leading to the outbreak of the revolutionary protest in France by putting dash mark are, then make the headings. Number one, social cause, write under it that society was divided under the three estate. You can draw that flowchart also. First estate, clergy, second estate, nobility, and third estate, the working classes. And they all three were not treated equally. First and second estate were getting all the privileges and rights but not paying taxes, and third estate were paying all the taxes. After that they were not getting any right. So it created dissatisfaction among the people and created revolution. Second is a political cause, that politically the system was worse, and the Louis XVI was following the policy of divine right. The will of the ruler was the law basically. And the political system was very inefficient. Why it was inefficient? Because all the appointments were not on the basis of skill and ability. It was on the basis of birth privileges. So created dissatisfaction among the people. Cause revolution, revolutionary conditions. Financial cause, that financially also France was not having a good condition. France was already engaged in a long drawn wars earlier. Secondly, Louis XVI and its all ministers expended lots of amount to live a luxurious life. So France was in the condition of bankruptcy. So as to manage the expenses, they increased the taxes and again, which created revolt among the people in the society because it was paid only by the third estate. And fourth, role of philosopher, or you can write the psychological cause also, right? Fourth mein aap psychological cause bhi likh sakte hain ya role of philosopher. So philosopher played a very important role. They changed the mind or the psychology of the people. They aware the people about their right, given the concept of the social contract or the division of the power. And mainly by the middle class scholars raised their voice, and revolution was started with the new demands and rights. Finally, the sudden cause related to equal voting right, you remember I discussed with you. So sudden cause, that finally in 1789, when the third estate demanded for the equal voting right, Louis XVI simply denied for it. So at the same time that people belonging to the prosperous middle classes, belonging to the third estate, quit the court and they given verdict to form their own constitution for the France. And at the same time, all throughout the France, in the city or in the countryside, revolution was starting. So these all five are the main points for this first question. Okay, you write the heading and write a short paragraph under the 4-5 line only. Only 3-4 lines you write to clear the meaning. ठीक है, आप इस हेडिंग को क्लियर करने के लिए 4-5 लाइन का छोटा सा पैराग्राफ लिख के समझा देंगे. दस यू कंप्लीट द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. देन सेकंड क्वेश्चन, सेकंड क्वेश्चन इज गिवन टू यू. आई हैव टू मैनेज द फोन ऑल्सो. Second question, which group of French society benefited from the revolution and which groups were forced to relinquish power? Which section of society would have been disappointed with the outcome of the revolution? So this second question, hope you have understood or not. So very easy answer, ki kaun se logon ko sabse zyada fayda hua hoga. So written this answer also for you. So you do it as in a heading wise. Groups benefited from the revolution. The richer members of the third estate benefited the most, which include the big businessmen, merchants, court officials, lawyers, etc. Groups, second part is asking, group which were forced to relinquish power. So which group? The first estate clergy and second estate nobility were forced to relinquish the power. And third part of the question is asking, who were disappointed group? Simply, naturally, the privileged classes, that were clergy and nobility, would have been surely disappointed as their privileges were taken away from them after the revolution. At the same time, the very poor, means in the third class, those who were very poor, so that poorer section of the society also disappointed as the promises of equality was not fulfilled in a full measure. Okay, so this is the second answer. Then the third question. Third question is asking about, describe the legacy of the French Revolution for the peoples of the world during the 19th and 20th century. So that legacy, I'm giving you through the points. Legacy of the French Revolution. So legacy of the French Revolution, you marked under the point. It inspired revolutionary movements in almost every country of Europe and rest other parts of the world. Second, it spread the new ideas of equality, liberty and fraternity. Third, it initiated a spirit of nationalism. Fourth, feudal system and later colonizations were also abolished. Fifth, Indian leaders like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Tipu Sultan, that period of time, were deeply influenced by ideas of French Revolution and initiated in the country to set up republic system in India. So these 5 points you add under the legacy of the French Revolution. Okay, then the fourth question is asking, fourth question, draw up a list of a democratic right we enjoy today whose origin could be traced to the French Revolution. So approximately all the rights we are enjoying today granted by our Indian constitution surely anyhow is inspired from that French Revolution. I have marked here. You carry the statement from your question and then make the point. Okay, remember that I have given directly to make you understand, but you first carry the statement of your question, then write the points. Clear? So first point, right to equality we carry from there. Second, right to freedom. Third, cultural and educational rights. Right to religious freedom. Right against exploitation. And sixth is right to constitutional remedies. These are the basic rights that we people or in our country India is also traced from the French Revolution. Then fifth question is asking, would you agree with the view that the message of universal right was beset with the contradiction? Explain. Yes, of course, we can consider it. In short, I summarize it. It's not basically very important question, but that contradiction should be clear to you. So, yes, the message of universal right was beset with the contradiction. All the citizens have the right to participate in its formation. It was considered earlier. All citizens are equal before it. But when France became constitutional monarchy, almost 3 million citizens, including men under the age of 25 and women, were not allowed to vote at all. So how it can be considered that the single view? So this was in a striking contrast to the ideals that the revolutionary espoused. So in this way, of course, this idea was contradictory. Okay? So these are the starting five question. Sixth question is, how would you explain the rise of Napoleon? Okay, this I have not written, so you can take help of the last paragraph, page number 23. In the page number 23, conclusion is given you about the Napoleon Bonaparte. So here in short paragraph is given you. You collect some of the lines here. No need to write that complete paragraph. Okay. Don't write or carry that complete paragraph. You use your own language. So what you will write here, question was that about the how would you explain the rise of Napoleon. So Napoleon got, you start with that Napoleon got an a golden opportunity to rule over the France, mainly firstly in the 1799 when the rule of Directory was not successful due to the political instability or due to the clashes among the directors. So that clashes anyhow created problem, or it proved the rule of Directory very inefficient. So this opportunity was taken by Napoleon, and then Napoleon entered here in France and they also became the part of French power. But finally or completely in 1804 he got the power over, full final authorization over the France. So in 1804 Napoleon finally crowned himself emperor of the France, and he set out the conquer neighboring European countries.